This is what my edges look like currently. And in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you the top oils you can use to grow your edges back fast. Now, I do have tons of videos on how to grow your edges back, and I'm going to tell you exactly what oils and how to use them to get your edges to grow back fast, or just to get them a little fuller, a little healthier, because it is everybody's weakest point of their hair. It's the finest hair, it's right in the front of your hair, and it needs the most care. So these are the best oils to grow your edges back fast. If you don't know me, my name is Angelica. I post videos twice a week, every single week, all about growing long, healthy hair. Sometimes I post a little bonus video, so if that seems interesting, consider subscribing. The subscription button is right down there, as well as the bell icon. Make sure you hit the bell so you get notifications every single time I post, and I always post my makeup details on my Instagram, which is AngieB with 3 underscores. Let's get into these oils. Okay, so I'm going to list these oils sort of in order of importance, aka I'm saving the best for last, okay, because it's very necessary in this one. So anyway, the first thing you can do is to use whatever oil you have, but if you don't have one currently, I would suggest, if you need to buy them and you only have money to, let's say, buy one, I always suggest getting an oil that you can do multiple things with, like olive oil, because you can cook with it, you can use it for your hair, you can make oil mixes, you can do a bunch of things with it. So I would suggest olive oil and avocado oil. Those two are amazing. The reason why those are good for your hairline is because they are not too thick, they're not too thin, they absorb into your hair shafts. So olive oil contains a lot of antioxidants, which your hair actually needs. And if you're using it on your hairline, you can keep your hair nice and soft and hydrated to the shaft. Make sure you remember that oils are not moisturizers. I'll get into that a little bit later, but oils do not moisturize. They can help seal it in temporarily, but it's actually the antioxidants and other benefits that it has that will really benefit your hair. And so putting some olive oil on your hairline can actually really help you retain the length. The next oil that will be beneficial for your hairline is a sealing oil like castor oil. Now, I love castor oil for the hairline because it is very thick. I don't always put castor oil all over my hair, but on the hairline, not every day, again, because it's very thick, it can actually cause hydro fatigue. Although oils don't moisturize, the fact that it's just a thick oil weighing your hair down might be a little too much, but putting a little castor oil, let's say every other day, or when it feels like your hair needs a little more oil, I highly suggest it for the front of your hair, especially because most of us wash off the moisturizer and the oils off the front of your hair. So you can actually get away with oiling your hairline literally every day. But with castor oil, I would say at least skip a day because it is super thick. It is very good to use castor oil on your edges because it actually helps thicken hair, which is what you need in the front, because most people have a thinner hairline. Most people don't have thick hair all the way to the edge of the hairline, even me. Most people have slightly thinner hair, but you can do whatever you can to make it as thick as possible. Castor oil is one of the oils that's been approved by dermatologists. They have done research and they actually show that yes, castor oil does in fact thicken hair, which is why people love it, mostly for the hairline. Like, if you don't use it anywhere else on your hair, use it on your hairline. Castor oil actually contains some protein and nutrients, but mostly fatty acids that will prevent the bulging of your hair follicles, which keeps your hair follicles healthy. And when you have healthy follicles, you have a healthy hair shaft. So that's why I always say focus on your scalp. If you just focus on the ends of your hair, if you're just touching up the little ends of your edges, it's not really going to do much. You really have to focus on the scalp, and castor oil really helps with thickness when it comes to that. So what I mentioned about the fatty acids, castor oil is mostly fatty acids, and the main one is rhinoleic acid. And studies have shown that rhinoleic acid, when applied to the scalp, can actually help open up your blood vessels. Blood vessels will be dilated, and when your blood vessels are dilated, that allows for lots of blood flow to go to that area. And when there's lots of blood flow, it means it's carrying oxygen. The oxygen is also going to boost the hair growth. And I think by far castor oil is one of the most popular oils when it comes to growing your edges. So if I could recommend one thickening oil, it would be castor oil. If you like, you could mix the olive oil and castor oil together to get most of the benefits. Okay, so the next oils are by far what I would say the most effective oils. These two oils, they don't necessarily boost your hair growth, like I said, but they can help with thickness, they can help with the health of your hair, so that when your hair grows the way it grows naturally, you can retain it faster, which is not a bad thing, because most people don't have long hair because you're not retaining the length fast enough. It's not because your hair is not growing fast enough, not to mention genetics are involved. But if you grow your hair 1 inch a month and you break off like 3/4 of an inch, and my hair grows 1/2 inch and only like a tenth of an inch breaks off, I will have hair that technically grows faster than yours, but you're just breaking yours faster. So ignore the genetics. There's nothing you can do about your genetics, but what you can do is make sure that you retain as much length as possible. Now, the next essential oils I'm going to give actually help boost your hair growth as well. So these ones are my favorite. There are so many essential oils out there and you can do your own research. But what I'm talking about specifically in this video are oils I have personally used that I have seen huge changes and benefits from myself. So there is peppermint oil. If you're not new to this channel, you know I love peppermint oil so much. Peppermint oil is one of the most stimulating oils. You can literally feel it on your scalp. It's the menthol in it that sends blood flow to your scalp. It creates a tingling sensation. And I don't know if it's just me, but I love oils that give a tingling sensation because it feels like it's working, because it is. And when you do this with peppermint oil, not only does it leave you feeling refreshed, but it actually... Research has been done, unfortunately, on mice a long time ago. Hopefully it hasn't been done on mice again recently. But when research was done a long time ago, it showed that peppermint oil actually increases the depth of your follicle, which is something you really need for your edges, because on your hairline, it's very possible that the follicles are very close to the roots of your hair, to your scalp, because it's so easy for the hair to just kind of rip out when you're combing it, when you're brushing it. Aside from it usually being softer than most places, if the follicle depth is a little deeper, that will mean your hair is going to be stronger, it's going to stay in the roots much longer. And also, like I said, the oxygen from the blood and the stimulation that's going to go to your scalp is actually going to really help with your hair growth. The next one that is similar is tea tree oil. It also has the same tingling effect, not as much as peppermint oil, but what the good thing about tea tree oil is it is antibacterial and it is antimicrobial. So if you happen to have anything like itching, or if you wear wigs a lot, which actually will not be helpful for your edges. I talk about that in my other videos that are not focused on oils, but wearing wigs all the time is not going to help you. But if you happen to wear wigs and sort of cover up your edges a lot and it creates some sort of moisture, there could be bacteria that could be growing there that could be damaging your hairline, and the tea tree can actually really help with that, aside from giving you that refreshing and tingling sensation as well. So really look into tea tree oil. You can use one or all of these and mix them together. It is totally up to you, but I'm just giving you one. So like, let's say you say I want one essential oil and one carrier oil. You could use olive oil and peppermint oil, mix them together and make like a really good product for your hairline. But don't worry, we're going to talk about mixes soon and how to make them. So let's get into the third oil I suggest, and this is rosemary oil. I have been talking about this oil quite a lot on this channel lately, but know that there is a difference between rosemary extract oil, which is just extracted from the leaves that you can actually make yourself, and rosemary essential oils. They have very similar benefits, but slightly different at the same time. I would recommend either one, or if you have the money or want to try it, you can do both. But the rosemary essential oil is also amazing. Rosemary oil, out of most of the essential oils, aside from maybe peppermint oil, is one of the most researched oils and one of the oils that has shown some of the most results. And it is prescribed by dermatologists a lot, especially for people who don't want to go the route of using like prescribed medication like minoxidil and Rogaine, which are the popular ones. Rosemary has shown to be just as effective as those two, with less side effects, and also has more benefits when it comes to preventing itching and dandruff. Now, notice that if you have something like seborrheic dermatitis or something like that, that is something completely different, and you need to see a dermatologist to fix that, because if you have that kind of severe dandruff, adding oils might only aggravate it. So if you have that kind of an issue, speak to your dermatologist and they'll advise you. But anyway, rosemary oil is amazing. It actually boosts nerve endings. It can truly promote hair growth. It can extend your hair growth phase. It is just amazing, and I don't know why it is not more popular, because rosemary is like a gift from God. It is amazing. I have been using it so much more lately. So now let's go to number four, which is actually in my opinion, these are, if you're looking for something that's like, I want to guarantee hair growth, three specific oil mixes are my best so far. Now, I have made a bunch of oils on this channel and I have tried so many different oils. So trust me when I say I have tried all these oils and they are all amazing. It's best to try them one at a time. Don't try all of them because if they all really work well, you won't know which one worked better than the other. And if one doesn't work at all, you might just waste your money and you think it actually worked. Meanwhile, it was another oil. So I would say try like every 6 weeks to try one of these. And if one works exceptionally well, you don't have to keep switching and trying this one and trying this one just because I'm giving you ideas. Find one that really works well and then stick to that one. So the first one is moringa oil. Moringa oil is amazing because moringa is actually a superfood and it has so many different antioxidants and nutrients. And to make this oil mix, I call it an oil mix because the moringa is the main ingredient. Let's get into how to make that oil right now. I'm starting with a full cup of olive oil and then I just put 1.5 tablespoons of moringa. And now we are going to put this into some boiling hot water in a glass bottle. If you have a glass bottle that you're scared is going to break, try and just do this in a different container, maybe metal, but not plastic. So this is going to sit in the oil until it completely cools down. And then I left it to just sit overnight. And this is the next morning. We have the oil. What I love so much about this is you barely need to strain it because everything sinks to the bottom. Now I'm just straining this into a cup in case anything has come out, you know, and then I'm going to put it into my DoGrow bottle. Now I'm adding some castor oil and then I'm going on with some essential oils, but your base oil has to be something that penetrates your hair shaft. Okay, so if you've seen that and you think moringa is not really for me, I'm allergic to it, I don't really like it, not available where I am, not really my thing, I've got you. This oil is even easier. Now, this oil is a bomb and it is amazing for the hairline because not only does it boost your hair growth because of the caffeine, caffeine is another thing that's been used kind of like rosemary. If you see lots of hair growth treatments that are like, this is for preventing alopecia or helping with alopecia, usually traction alopecia, not alopecia areata, which again is something totally different. You need to speak to your dermatologist for that. But things like traction alopecia, premature balding, coffee oil, and just coffee in general is something that is highly recommended. You see caffeine shampoos and conditioners and deep conditioners. That is all got from the coffee. So this one is extremely easy to make. And another benefit is that it actually tints your hairline. So unfortunately, if you have like blonde hair or really light hair, colored hair, this might not be for you because it might actually discolor your hairline and that's not what you want. But also note that if you're constantly bleaching your hair and you're having problems with your edges, the bleach might be the problem. But if you want to use oils anyway and want to help yourself, the coffee oil might not be for you. But if it is, let's get to how to make the coffee oil. Want to switch on your stove on very, very low heat because we are going to be using oil and oil can burn and you don't want the oil to burn. You don't want the coffee to burn. So you're going to start by using 2 tablespoons of ground coffee. If you're just trying this for the first time, you could use 1 tablespoon just to test it out. And now I'm using 2 tablespoons of olive oil. I don't tend to like to heat up my oils to the point of boiling because I know that a few of the ingredients get denatured. However, to release the most important benefits of coffee, you do need to have it properly cooked. So there will be a way that I'll counteract this after I mix this, but at this stage, it's only 2 ingredients. You just want to keep it on the stove on very, very low heat for about 20 minutes. So this oil is actually very popularly made with coconut oil, and people love using coconut oil because it works so amazing for their hair. However, coconut oil doesn't work well for me, so I don't use coconut oil. Whatever your favorite carrier oil is, use that instead. So after that time, I add in castor oil. Now, I don't know if you can tell, but I did switch off the stove. So now it's off and I'm adding 2 full tablespoons of castor oil. And the reason I'm adding castor oil is because of the way I use it. I actually prefer this oil to be a little bit on the thicker side. So here I like to add it while it's still warm so that it can just liquefy and melt and mix together with all the other ingredients. As you can see, it's very, very liquidy because it's warm, but the stove is off. So now I just covered it with a lid and I let it sit for about 5 hours just to continue infusing and cool down. So now it's time to decant this into our little bottle. So this is my sieve, and I think it's kind of meant for like coffee or something like that. So it is extremely fine. It's almost like a cheesecloth, and that's why you see that it's taking a pretty long time for the oil to pass through, which is actually what I want because I don't want bits of coffee to get stuck in my hair. That is it made. So as you saw, I love making the coffee oil because it is super easy. These three are almost on par. They're almost the same. I think it just depends on which one your hair likes more. And the last one is my new favorite oil, and this is not the rosemary essential oil I was talking about earlier on. This is the rosemary extract, and I just did a video actually on how to make this rosemary oil. It is amazing for hair growth, okay? And there's so many different benefits. I actually have a whole video as well on how to make rosemary oil, but if you don't want that, you can get to a quick video of how to make the rosemary oil right now. And the first thing you want to do is thoroughly wash it to get any sand or dirt off of it, and then what I like to do is wrap it in a tea towel, and this is to make sure it absorbs all the water and the moisture because we don't want any water dripping into the oil. So as you see, I'm squeezing it, but not wringing it because I don't want to break the leaves. I'm just squeezing it to get out all the water, and you can see the leaves are basically completely dry, very nice and fresh and green. Now, even if it seems dry, I'm still going to put this back into the towel, wrap it up, and leave it there for a couple of minutes as I prepare everything else, just to make sure any little moisture that I can't see can be absorbed by the towel. And now we're going to the stove. We are going to be doing the double boiler method. So first I put the pot on the stove with a lid on just to make sure it boils quickly. And while that is boiling, we are starting to prepare the oil. So I'm using extra virgin olive oil. And when you're using extra virgin olive oil, you should always read the back to make sure that it shows that the only ingredient is extra virgin olive oil. Sometimes there could be a mix. So then I'm using a quarter cup. I always now only do quarter cup measurements and 1 tablespoon of castor oil. You can use whatever carrier oil or oils that you love best. So now we are just getting the leaves off and I'm just dragging them down. That's the easiest way to get, I don't know whether you can call them leaves, I guess it's sort of a leaf. So now the water is boiling by the time I was done with that. And once it's boiling, I reduce the temperature to almost off so that it's just like simmering. And then I put this metal bowl over the top because, like I said, we are doing the double boiler method. And the reason for this is so that none of the nutrients from the oils get denatured, but we can still extract all the nutrients from the rosemary. Now, the key thing you should do here is to make sure that the water does not touch the bowl. That is going to be almost the same as putting it straight onto the stove. So make sure that it's just the steam doing the work. So you want to mix and mix, and you're going to start to see that it's going to become a little bit cloudy, and it's not going to look so different, but the color will eventually change. So I can give you a specific time on how long to keep it, but I would say anywhere from 10 to 15 minutes. And once it starts to look not as green as it was before, and the oil is starting to look a little bit more cloudy, you know that it's done. Once that's done, I just turn off the burner and I move the oil off the stove, but I still leave it in the pot, as in on top of the pot, the double boiler, until it completely cools. And now this is what the oil looks like when it is done. We are going to strain out the rosemary, and I'm going to put this in a glass jar. If you have like a brown glass jar that's tinted, that would be better. But glass is always better than plastic. So if you have glass over plastic, choose that first. And if plastic is your only option, you can go ahead and use a plastic bottle. Now I'm taking my spoon because we do not waste here, and I'm just mushing all that cooked rosemary down to make sure that everything has gone in. And you can see the difference between the one that's been in the oil and the one that's been out. I'm going to put in a couple sprigs of fresh rosemary, about 3 of them. And this I just want to sit and continue to infuse in the oil as it sits. After about 2 weeks, or as soon as the rosemary changes color, I will take it out of the oil. And this is what it looks like. You really don't have to do this step, but to be honest, it's also very aesthetically pleasing. Let me know in the comment section below, out of all the oils I've listed for your edges, which one is your favorite and which one can you not wait to try? I would love to know. Watch the full rosemary oil video right here if you want even more details about what's so amazing about it. Click my face right there to subscribe if you didn't in the beginning. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye!